My name is Lyle Massey. I work with OPI Systems, and today I'm going to show you how to change the battery out of a cable node. The equipment you need to do this procedure is a pair of small clippers, a Phillips head screwdriver, the replacement battery, and a pair of zip ties. The battery is located inside the cable node near the top of the PCB, nestled in between the solar panels. In order to access it, you need to use the Phillips head screwdriver to unscrew these three screws here, located at the base of the cable node. I'm going to go ahead and do so now. After you have unscrewed those three screws, you can remove the base from the cable node itself and have a look inside. You will see there are three more Phillips head screws. You will need to unscrew those as well. I'm going to go ahead and do that now. After you have removed those screws, the top plastic cover will pop off with a little bit of elbow grease. And now you have access to the battery. You will see the battery is being held there with three black zip ties. The first thing you should do, where the battery is plugged in on the left-hand side, unplug that from the printed circuit board. Next, you should use the clippers to unclip those three zip ties. At this time, you can remove the battery from its position. Now, remove these three zip ties. You'll need to force the top where you clipped it through the top half and then pull it out of the bottom half. Next, take your replacement battery, place it where you're going to put it, and get your two zip ties ready. They will be going on the outer two locations where you just removed your zip ties from. So similar to the way they were there, put the zip tie through and then pull it up through the top hole in the PCB, making sure to leave enough room for the battery after these are clipped in. Repeat the same process with the second zip tie on the other end of the PCB. Now, place the battery in a position where you can secure and tighten the zip ties around it. But before doing so, make sure the battery clip does not get tangled with the zip ties. At this time, you can go ahead and secure the zip ties. Once the zip ties are secure, tighten them so the battery itself does not move, and then clip the excess off so that that does not get in the way when you reconstruct the node. Now, at this time, you can reconnect the battery to its port on the PCB. Now you can begin reconstructing the cable node. Take the clear plastic cover and replace it in the position it was in prior to taking it apart. Once it is securely in place, you may start to replace the screws that you removed when you were taking it apart. These are the longer Phillips head screws. They go in one of the three positions inside the cable node. You can replace them and then finish tightening them after they are in. Don't forget to secure the base of your cable node. It will have one of these black chains with a metal P-clip on the end. When you put the last screw back in place, do not forget to first put it through this metal P-connector at the end of this black chain. This black chain securely connects the base to the cable node and keeps them in place. Now that you have replaced the battery, before sealing it up, don't forget to reactivate it by pulling the red jumper and making sure that it works. You will know that it works by the flashing blue and red lights. Put the base back on the cable node and using your Phillips head screwdriver, tighten the three exterior Phillips head screws. Now that you have replaced the cable node battery on your cable node, it is ready to be installed wherever it needs to go. If you have any questions concerning this process, give us a shout at 1-800-661-1055, or you can email us at help@opsystems.com. Thanks for your time and have a good day.